Hello, beautiful people, and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Tandisa Maya, and I talk all things relating to business, making money, and also family life. If you are a returning subscriber, thank you so very much for supporting this channel. And if you are very much new to our channel, make sure that you also take the opportunity to subscribe, especially if this content makes sense to you, my dear. Make sure that you also subscribe and click on that notification bell so that you are kept abreast of when you put out new videos and content that can be able to grow your life. All right, in this video, we are tackling once again another Make Money Tuesday video. And Make Money Tuesdays for us here in this community is about giving you ideas on what you can be able to start in terms of a business idea or a side hustle, or augmenting your existing income with something that you can be able to do, like offering value to people that are willing to pay for it. And in this video today, we are focused on how you can be able to start your very own brand, clothes reselling brand, or clothes reselling business. That is what we're talking about. I'm going to give you a couple of simple steps that you can be able to follow so that you are able to get that business off the ground or make some improvements on that existing business. Maybe you are struggling here and there, and this video may just be able to help you. Make sure that you stick around until the end, because it is the sequential application of these steps that will be able to get your business off the ground. All right, step number one, you need to decide on the kind of clothes that you would like to sell. And I say this all the time, like people who know me and follow my content will understand that I do not like the idea of just getting into a business and being generic. It is very important that you are able to be specific in terms of what you are going to be able to do in business, so that you stand out from the crowd, so that you are different, so that you are unique, so that you are attractive. Because I mean, we are all attracted to something unique, something different, something new, something specific. That is how we are designed as human beings. There is really not many people that love generic things. You know, we want something that is very specific. So even in this type of business idea, make sure that you start by deciding the kind of clothes that you want to sell. What do you want to specialize in terms of clothes? And trust me, every single day, people are buying clothes. The industry of clothes reselling is billions and billions and billions of dollars in value, and it is continuing to grow. There is no decline, but there are transitions in terms of how people are now doing their purchases, and the online world seems to be gaining a lot of strength. It is not really killing retail, walking into a shop kind of sales, but there is a whole opportunity that you can be able to make use of in the online world as well. So the first thing that you need to do, what kind of clothes do you want to sell? You know, do you want to specialize in just formal office wear? Is that what you want to do? Do you want to go with stylish, fashion-y type of clothes? Do you want to go with traditional clothing? Do you want to go with like clothing for a specific niche of people? Like for instance, if you want to sell clothes to people who are farmers, they use specific and certain types of clothes, and they're very expensive actually. They're willing to pay. That category of people actually can pay. So what kind of clothes would you like to sell in this clothes reselling shop or idea of yours? That's the first thing that you need to niche down on. You need to focus on, you need to give your attention on, you need to be determined about making the correct decisions around step number one. What kind of clothes would you like to sell? Do not be generic, be as specific as you can. The other thing that will help you in this process of actually unpacking step one for yourself is actually having a category, a specific category of people or clients that you're going to focus on. Think about the kind of people that you want to target, the kind of people that you want to come through and buy your clothes. Who are those people? So that you can be able to have them in mind and actually also have a matching type of or category or kind of clothing that you can resell to them that matches what they are requiring or the style that they want, so that you know exactly where target audience is, and you know exactly what will you be then offering to them as value in terms of the clothing that you're going to be selling to them. Step number two, you need to now go and find suppliers. Suppliers are the key. Suppliers are key, but you cannot go and find suppliers without knowing who you are going to be selling clothes to, without knowing who your target audience is, without knowing the kind of clothing that you'll be selling. That is why this step follows the first one. In this second step, you go now and investigate suppliers. There are so many different ways for you to be able to find suppliers. You can literally use the internet. You can literally go online and search out different on different platforms. You can use TikTok, you can use YouTube, you can use Facebook, you can use Google. You can literally go on any search engine and go or social media platform and inquire about specific suppliers of the specific clothes that you're looking for. The second thing that you need to keep in mind with suppliers is what you want is you do not want to find one supplier, but you want to find a couple of suppliers. And what you're going to do is you're going to compare price, quality, turnaround times, delivery options, and things like that, because you want to be able to classify the different options of suppliers that you have and choose the best that is going to ensure that you offer the best service to your clients, because you are going to be building a community of clients that are going to be requiring the kind of clothing that you're going to be selling, and you do not want to get stuck at the supplier level, because a supplier can literally kill your business. So you need to make sure that you give enough time to finding the correct suppliers, and a correct supplier is dependent on the quality of clothing that they provide and the variety of style that they have, how much they charge, the conditions in terms of bulk buying and buying items, a few items. Do they say that you can only buy 50 units of the same thing? Do they say that you can have the same thing but different colors? So there are so many things to consider when it comes to the supplier. But the second thing that you need to do is to go and spend time in identifying reputable suppliers that you can be able to make use of. Please take note that there are suppliers out there, people that are posing as suppliers, but that are just ripping people off, scammers. So you're also going to need to have ways to check how real the supplier is, so that you are not finding yourself in a situation where you are getting a fake supplier. I also fell into that trap at some point. But I have learned that there are so many ways that I need to actually make sure that I vet a supplier and ensure that this supplier is legit, so that I do not set myself up for failure or find that in the situation that I found myself in, I lose money just because I did not do the vetting process. So make sure that you do the vetting process to ensure that a supplier is real and is not a scammer. Be on the lookout for reviews. Be on the lookout to see how people are commenting on their websites, on their platforms where they're advertising, where you get their contact numbers and things like that. You will be able to vet a supplier easily if you already know that you need to vet a supplier before you commit to it. That's the second step. All right. Now that you have, let's assume that now you have found your supplier and you're good to go. Let's assume that you have found your supplier or a couple of suppliers and you have tested and vetted them, and now you're ready to move. You know exactly where you're going to be sourcing your goods from, which is your clothing from. And you know the times, the turnaround times, the quality, you know the pricing structure and everything. Step number three is for you to determine what your markup percentage is going to be and what you're going to be doing with your courier. Right, so when it comes to your markup percentage, obviously, because you'll be reselling and not producing the clothing items from scratch, it means that there is already a cost that you need to incur to get your hands on the clothing items so that they get to where you are, right? So that they get into, like, you fit them into your brand. So there's already a cost there. You need to calculate how much that cost is and be very specific. Do not leave out anything. If there's shipping, if there is customs, anything that you need to calculate in terms of costing, how much it has costed you to get the item to where you are. Now, what will be your markup percentage? I think the one workable model in this space when you are a clothes reseller is actually just using a markup percentage. So once you have calculated all your costs, then what will be your markup percentage? You can decide to make it 20%, 3%, 100%, whatever, depending on how good a deal you get, and also depending on your target audience. If your target audience is in the lower LSM where they don't have much money, obviously, you will not be able to increase your profit margin to put that percentage higher. But if you are targeting high end or at the midpoint, obviously, you can increase slightly. And at the high end, you know that your target audience is expensive people, like people with expensive taste and people who've got money, people who can be able to pay. So you can play around better in terms of your markup percentage. And then the next thing that you need to do is to also factor in courier. If you are going to, like, it depends on the model that you're going to implement, but if you are going to be delivering straight to a person's door, like to a client's door, you need to also calculate, do not forget that amount for courier cost. And this also means you need to investigate which courier company locally in South Africa, for an example, is the cheapest, most reliable, you know, with quicker turnaround times, because you want your client to get the products to them as quickly as possible. There is nothing that is boring as getting your product, you know, delivered way late. I know that it depends on how you build your community, but you want to, at the same time, while your community might be understanding, at the same time be at the front and ahead of ensuring that your client gets their stuff as soon as possible. Like, that should be your focus. Step number four. Now that you have gotten all these steps down and you are good to go, now you need to focus on building an online presence. Now, this is very much important. If you are going to be selling your clothes online, you need to build an online presence. Now, there are so many different ways that you can be able to use. I know a couple of people that just use social media. I know a couple of people that use a website and merge it into social media. In online clothes reselling space, you can be able to go different routes. One route that you can be able to take is to build a website and ensure that you build your entire website with all the clothing that you're offering, that you're selling online, and build that and sell right from your website. There you're able to have a lot of control on different things, and you seem more professional when you have a website. I don't know how, but it's just how the structure, the marketplace operates. When you have a website, you are much more professional, you seem organized, you seem like you are structured. What you're saying, selling is much more real. Other people do not go the route of having a website. They just use social media, like literally going on TikTok, setting up an account and putting out good quality content that relates to or pushes people to actually make a purchase of your clothes that you're selling. You could also do the same on Facebook. You can also do the same on Instagram. It really, really does work. But I've seen people, I think people who maximize this the most are people who are able to still have a foundation as a website and link the socials to the website, which means that you use the socials to push people to the website and all the transactions happen on the website. And I think that gives a whole lot more control of a lot of different dynamics, right? Because with social media, you can find that you can lose your account at any point, or you could be hacked, you could be scammed. There's a lot of things that happen, but there's a percentage that goes into the negative side of social media that could affect your business. But there's also, you know, those things could also happen with your website. But when you're weighing the two, obviously the website brings a lot of security. And with a website, you can also be able to collect your customers' details for future reselling, upselling, reselling, telling them about sales, like having a communication and building a whole email list. That's a whole topic altogether, because you can make a lot of money through your email list as well. So I think it really depends on where you are in your business journey, financially and in terms of resources, in terms of how you decide. If you are, you know, financially not in a great position and you don't want to invest heavily in your business, you know, front end, so you can just use social media to start and use the money that you will generate from your first couple of sales to build the website and build the other side of having that foundation, so that you can be able to build your brand as big as you can, you know. But other people have got fully successful brands that are built off of just using social media. But what I'm trying to drive home is that you need to make a decision as to how you are going to be showing up with an online presence. You know, how will people find you in the online space? So you need to intentionally build an online presence. That's the next step. The next thing that you need to now do is to market your business intentionally, intensely, immensely. Make sure that you go out there and market your business. Now, if you're going to be building an online clothes reselling store, online clothes reselling business, an online clothes reselling brand, you need to then also market your business online. That means there are so many different things that you can do around the clothes reselling space or around the clothing space. You could do tips, clothing tips. You could do trending styles in terms of, like, with clothes, most there's always changes in terms of whatever niche that you have chosen in the first step. But there's always changes in winter. These kind of people like to dress this way in summer, in spring, colors that are relevant during the time and things like that. Even keep on dressing yourself and showing up every single day, showing up, showing up, showing up. And then as you are dressing yourself, you say, you can get this at my shop. for X amount, or get the style and hollow more styles at my shop, things like that. I mean, coming up with a marketing strategy using social media is my best strength, but it's really something that you can also do, my dear. It's something that you can also apply today, not any other day. Just it will take time, but with gradual and consistent implementation of the strategy itself, you can be able to see a lot of difference in your business. So make sure that you market your business as much as you can. And lastly, what you need to do is to consistently improve on your customer service so that you can build loyalty, so that you can build trust with your customers, so that they can be able to know that they can rely on this brand. Your customer service every single day, think about how you can be able to improve it, how you can make it better, because that the customer will not forget. That's why when a customer gets bad service, they will always remember it. And you do not want any kind of bad publicity around your customer service. People can say a lot of different things about your brand or your business, but they don't open the door for them to say negative things about your customer service. And be very strategic, even when you are resolving customer issues and customer problems, customer complaints and challenges around the customer space. Make sure that you are very strategic so that you do not find yourself on the negative end of any customer as much as you can, especially when your brand is still very small. You want to have a lot of strength. You want to build a lot of strength through customers saying the right things or the correct things about your brand. And that is it for today. That is how you can be able to start your online clothes reselling brand, online clothes reselling business today. Comment in the comment section and tell me which idea do you have that you can roll out around the clothes, online clothes reselling space. Like, what has been your interest? What has been your dream? What has been your idea? And where have you been stuck at? Maybe I can be able to assist. Thank you so much for tuning in. Do not forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you can be kept abreast when we have got new content that you can be able to get right here on our platform. That is all from me for today. Until next time, stay absolutely blessed.